Welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be talking about how to find the equation of a line today. And in this particular problem, we're given two pieces of information, in this case, two points. One is the point 2, 3, and the other is the origin, which of course is the point 0, 0. So using these two points and the slope-intercept equation of the line in slope-intercept form, we will find the equation of a line that connects these two points. So remember that this is slope-intercept form, y equals mx plus b, and that m is the slope, which we find by subtracting y1 from y2 and dividing that by x2 minus x1. Remember that b is the y-intercept of our line. So the first thing that we'll do is go ahead and find m, the slope. And the way that we do that, remember we have two points, and one of them is the point x(1, y)(1), these two points here, and the other is the point x(2, y)(2), these two numbers right here. So I usually find it easier to assign the point x(2, y)(2) to whichever of our points has larger values. In this case, our first point is 2, 3, and the second point is 0, 0. So 2, 3 has larger values in it than 0, 0. So I would assign that to be x(2, y)(2) because we're going to be subtracting the smaller point from the larger point. And if we do that, we'll end up with positive values. And that's just easier to work with. But it doesn't really matter. You could assign x(2, y)(2) to either and x(1, y)(1) to either of the points. It's really inconsequential. But I'm going to say that 2, 3 is x(2, y)(2). And that 0, 0 is x(1, y)(1). So in that case, realize that we're that we have the y-coordinates here in the numerator of our slope fraction. So we'll take y(2), which in our case is 3. Remember, we're treating this first point as x(2, y)(2). The y-coordinate there is 3. And the y-coordinate in x(1, y)(1) is 0. So in the numerator of our slope fraction, we end up with 3 minus 0. For x(2) minus x(1), of course, x(2) we grab from our first point, and that's 2, and then subtract from that x(1), which we get from the origin, so the point is 0. So in the denominator, we end up with 2 minus 0. And we just plug that whole thing in for m, ignoring everything else for now. The easiest way to go about this is find m first, then plug in one of the points to solve for b. So we'll start moving in that direction now. So first of all, we can simplify our slope fraction. 3 minus 0 in the numerator gives us 3. 2 minus 0 in the denominator gives us 2. So our slope is 3 halves, which means that every time the line moves up 3 units, right? The y-coordinate is in the numerator. It moves up 3 units. It also moves to the right 2 units. So the change, it's change in y over change in x. The change in y is 3. It moves up 3. The change in x is 2. It moves over 2. Positive 3 and positive 2. But anyway, that's our slope. And then we can plug in either one of these points. It doesn't matter. But I'll go ahead and plug in 2, 3. So I plug in 3 for y and 2 for x. 3 for y right here and 2 for x here. And now solving this equation for b will give us the last piece of information we need to write the equation of the line. So when we multiply this out, the 2's here will cancel, one in the denominator and one in the numerator, and we'll be left with 3 equals 3 plus b. Subtracting 3 from both sides gives us b equals 0. So now if we look back here at the equation of the line, y equals mx plus b, we just found that b was equal to 0, which makes sense because b is the y-intercept. And if our line intersects the y-axis at 0, that means it passes through the origin, which was indicated in the original problem. So b is equal to 0, and we already found that the slope was equal to 3 halves, m was equal to 3 halves. So the equation of this line is y equals 3 halves x, and we leave y and x as they are, and that's our final answer. You can leave it in this form. You could simplify by multiplying both sides by 2 to get 2y equals 3x, or move the variables onto one side. It doesn't really matter unless you're asked specifically for a slope-intercept form or point-slope form or whatever, but we'll leave our equation as y equals and then an equation in terms of x. So anyway, I hope that video helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!